We do not teach individuals how to deal with their emotions, but we often knock children for what they don't know and what they haven't been taught. We often hold children to unrealistic expectations because we as adults expect for children to be compliant when they don't have the ability to deal with and understand and process their emotions. There's a grounding exercise where you use the five senses, you know, where you can say, you know, and you can do it with your classroom and you can do it at the start of the day. Hey, I want you guys to make sure that we're in our bodies and make sure that we're ready to learn. I want you to find five things. I want you to find five things that you can see. I want you to find four things and identify four things that you can hear. I want you to identify three things that you can smell. I want you to identify, you know, two things that you can touch and one thing that you can taste. So, you know, that allows for the students that are coming into your classrooms, if they have come from something that has been bad, if they have come from, you know, they got out the car and they were getting yelled at and cursed at this morning because they didn't do what their parents asked them to do because they were focused on other things, or if they had a bad night last night, or if they went to a class before your class, if they're in high school or middle school and there was something bad that happened and they're not in a good place, helping them ground before they even start is a good thing. Being mindful and allowing them to be intentional about their days and about their actions.